One of the consequences is this. It gives a wonderful reason why you have individuals who are prodigies. Haven't you noticed somebody masters mathematics, Mozart mastering music at the age of 6 and 7? And people say, why? How does this happen? And of course, they'll ask Richard Dawkins, it's just genetic mutation, kind of accidental mutation. That's why this guy is a genius. No, no, says reincarnation, there's something else at play. The reason why that individual is a prodigy in a particular field, has mastered that field, is because in his many previous lives, he focused on that particular discipline and became master on it. And this is why it's becoming revealed at a very early stage in his life. It gives wonderful explanation about why you have prodigies, why different individuals have different tendencies and different attractions, why somebody is attracted to music, why somebody to mathematics or whatever. It tells us exactly that the background has already fashioned you to go for it as soon as you are born. From early stage, early life, you start to focus on it. The other things that come out of reincarnation, they also give you a wonderful reason why we have phobias, irrational fear, fear that cannot be explained away. Most of us suffer from some phobia or other. Reincarnation says, really speaking, the reason why you have phobias is, it is very possible that in one of your previous lives, you met your death in this particular manner. That's why you're frightened of it. Look, I'll give you my personal secret example. I fear heights. I really get frightened. My daughter puts me in those Ferris wheels, and when it stops at the top, she says, Daddy, look down. I say, no, I'm going to die. And I hang on to the bar as if I'm going to fall off and die instantly. Why? Very likely in one of my previous life, I fell off a great height. That memory of that life is gone, but the fear remains at the back of my head. So when I am exposed, I get very fearful for no reason. It gives an interesting, not I'm saying that all phobias are reincarnation. I can't do that. Be careful. In many cases, things can be sorted out. Because if you look at the modern psychologists, they'll say, oh, well, we can explain it because when the little child was a youngster, he fell off the stool and he's frightened of ice. And, oh, it's not really rational enough. It's not solid. Why is this severe fright? Of course, they'll go to Dr. Freud and say, Dr. Madame, this child is frightened because he must have fallen down. And the mother said, no, he never fell down. I looked after him very well, never fell off. Oh, in that case, says Dr. Freud, Madame, after you had conceived, you fell off the stool. Now, this is really stretching it. So I'm telling you, even modern psychology can benefit dramatically by accepting reincarnation as a reason why we have certain tendencies, certain fears, certain phobias, or certain skills. It's a wonderful way to get a deeper insight into our background. So this is a second area, a very interesting area. But there is a third area which I want to focus on, is this. Reincarnation, the reason why it is crucial and important to again reignite it in modern societies as follows. It gives us, tells us, whatever you started to participate in, suppose you're becoming master in music or whatever, suppose you die suddenly. Please do not worry. Your journey does not come to a halt. You will again start from where you left off. You don't have to start from zero again. So the activities we do in this life, the character we mold for ourselves in this life, is perhaps the most important thing that we have, which goes from one life to another life. The character we mold for ourselves is the most important thing. And reincarnation tells us, focus on your character. Because sometimes people say, how does, sometimes when people make fun of law, karma, saying, my karma catching up. How does it catch up? This is how it catches up in your next life. Whatever activity you do has left its seeds in your psyche. When you go, this mass of this thing comes with you and begins to reveal itself. Suppose you are a very honest person, very upright, very focused individual. In your next life, you're already focused individual from childhood. So you get the benefit of what you set into motion in your previous life in this life because it comes out as your character. It's another philosophic issue that reincarnation addresses which many religions struggle with. Suppose you ask people of religion, why is this person so horrible, he's a cold-blooded killer, kills people, millions of people were killed by this man. He must be straight out of the devil or evil. The Indic tradition, all the four Indian religions do not agree there is a devil or evil. They say, this is what they say. They say the reason why people are different, some are sweeties and some are really cruel, it's not because they are inherently cruel. He says, through the process of reincarnation, they may have gone through a pathway which made them very cruel. Look, the theory of reincarnation accepts Darwin and theory of evolution. We have no difficulty with evolution. All the Indic religions agree we have come out of the animal kingdom. And reincarnation started a long time back while you are animals. So some of the vicious traits that we possess, and human beings possess, perhaps came out because they came out through that particular route where they had to be vicious, it was a matter of survival. And they show this, they continue to exhibit this tendency in the human character, in the human life. So there's nobody essentially evil, they've just gone through a scenic route and they show these colors in this human life. When you see this, this gives you like tremendous dignity and equality to whole of humanity, saying you come through a different path, that's why you're a bit weird, but so be it, we'll soon sort you out. A wonderful way of getting a deeper insight into the human condition, nature of human nature. So if you just receive it to this life, then you've got a very limited scope. See, the other question people ask, and this is, you should, of course, you're going to fire away questions at me, but Mr. Lakhani, the world population is growing. You know, we started with literally 100,000, or with the time of Lucy, maybe one or two individuals, and now there are 7 billion. Where do all this come from? The answer is, from the animal, from the insect, from the single cell bacteria, to the insect, to the animal, to the plants, to the human. Huge flow of life. 7 billion is nothing. You can have trillions here. So much life entering the human kingdom. And it sticks around here. So evolution, in a way, gives a very interesting example. There's something else I must point out to show the scientific study that I make of this subject. You see, I'm suggesting that we agree with Darwin that the body that we possess has been fashioned by accidents of evolution and natural selection. So this is why we become this complex. So far, so good. But one thing Darwin has not touched on, which comes out of the Indic religions, is this. It's not just the hardware that's important. The software that runs the hardware or inhabits this hardware, where does that come from? You require a software, you've got a computer, hard drive. If you don't put any software, you just get a blinking cursor in your face, nothing happens. But the software that's inherited by that body, we say, comes through reincarnation. This is Mr. Lakhani. Maybe it's already hardwired in the DNA. How do you say it's a separate thing? It's a separate thing. I'll give you an example. Have you noticed, throughout our life, we continue to progress, become more focused, we can master a lot of things, from childhood to becoming mature adult, your DNA remains the same. So when you reproduce, the DNA has not moved one bit, not one ounce. And yet the new individual who comes out comes with different traits. It's the software, not the hardware. And the software comes through reincarnation.
Free e-learning course in Hinduism. To register, please visit www.hindu-academy.com.
Talks on Hinduism, sponsored by People Care, encouraging caring for the elderly in their own homes. For more information, please visit peoplecare.com.